It's now time to take the PowerMesh tracking data we created in Mocha Pro in exercise 7 and use that to remove another section of wire that crosses the body. In addition to this PowerMesh workflow between Mocha and Silhouette, I'll be talking about creating invisible blends using paint and rotor. Okay, back in Silhouette, we have our Mocha Pro module. Let's rename this one immediately to PowerMesh, bottom right. And I'm going to put the frame number in there straight away so we won't forget. Because if you don't do that, you will forget. Do you know how I know? I've forgotten. Good. Okay, and let's have another paint. Paint node in here. Come to frame 23, because that's the frame we're going to be painting on. This one here. Okay, so I'm just going to get rid of the wire all across down here. Let's rename this paint wire bottom right 23. Frame 23, remember. And I'm going to use the drag tool one more time. Let's remember to turn on our overlays. If we don't turn on our overlays, we won't see our brush, of course. Let's zoom in. So why do I like using the drag tool here? Well, one of the reasons is because we're dealing with this sort of continuous tone. I find that the drag tool will blend better, especially in the first instance, between the different colors. So it means I can get like a nicer, there we go, just get like a nicer blend between them all. So I'm just dragging and following the direction of the colors in the skin already. If I make a mistake, just undo, go back, make that smaller. Okay. I'm going to come down here. This is another one. Should I use a different tool? Possibly, but I'm kind of happy with my drag tool. Just going to drag that out. There we go. I'm going to just be nice making that. All those shadows and folds in the dress. There we go. Kind of nice. Don't be afraid if you've made like a bit of a strange edge here. You don't think works entirely. Just come to your eraser tool. And I'm going to take the opacity down to maybe about 5. I'm going to then turn on build up here. And what I can do with this is I can just bring back gently the original area. If I go too far, you can easily see the wire coming back in. I can just sort of bring in the skin tone. If I've gone a bit too wild with the drag tool, I can bring back the original there. It's all about just trying to create a natural transition. I think that's fine. And that's probably fine.
Yeah.
There we go. Cool. Good. All right. So we painted on frame 23. We only want to use frame 23. Let's come over back to our time. Hold on frame 23. So it's going to get fun. I'm going to make a copy of my PowerMesh one, the bottom right PowerMesh. I'm going to just Control Command C, Control Command V, and I'm going to pipe my hold into the PowerMesh. Okay, nothing has changed at all. I'm going to come to Module Renders in Mocha Pro. I'm going to go Stabilize Warp. And let's hit render on that. Nothing's changed, right? Yeah. Okay. What's the magic number we've been looking at all the way through from PowerMesh? Frame 23. Our paint, frame 23. Now let's play that through and let's see what happens when we play back on frame from frame 23 to frame 57. Ooh, that's interesting, isn't it? Yeah. kind of see what that's doing. That's now warping in that little patch that we've created. It's warping it in using the power mesh warp. So it's giving us a sort of smoother, almost more 3D feel to it. Now, obviously this isn't exactly right. So let's now comp this over the top. And I'm going to need to create a mask for this. Now, because I want to sort of maintain a bit of flexibility here, I'm going to add another roto node. We're going to use this roto node quite a bit, actually. So I will call this one wire roto, or wires roto. I'll create a new layer. And I'm just going to do a very basic track just on the back of her dress here, just to drive the rest of the roto so that I'm not chasing my tail a little bit. We could probably use one of the other rotos, but you know, it only takes a second to track this through, so it doesn't really matter. It's fine. Okay, it doesn't have to be the most accurate roto either, because I'm just using it to generate up the mats for the wires. Let's call this one back roto. I will turn off my square and let's come in and actually draw in our wires. Trusty X splines, bring that in there. And this is going to be wire bottom right. Transform that into place. Should be just like a couple of keyframes to do this. Boom, boom. We'll tidy this up later. It's going to be proof of concept right now. Make sure that's all right. Yeah, that's looking all right. It's fine. Cool. So let's bring all this together. Let's add a composite node. Composite, bring this down here. Pump the wires into the composite. Pump my power mesh into the background. So let's swap those around. There we go. Quick proof of concept. I think that's going to work out all right. So we're just going to feather this up, get the roto looking a bit better on the side there. And I think that's going to work out all right. You know, just clean up things like the hair and stuff. We'll work on how we're going to get the hair looking good a little bit later. But that's how we can start to use power mesh on areas where we have the wire crossing the body and the body is moving around. In this exercise, we've seen one of the most useful paint techniques available for wire removal over a moving body. This takes the reverse stabilization techniques that have been a mainstay for many years, and it cranks it up to meet more difficult challenges. Power mesh significantly reduces the need for frame by frame paint, and it gives a clean result faster. So I'm going to do that exact same thing on the other side. So coming from frame, where's it going to be? From frame 71 to 101 to try and do it on this side here. And it's going to be the same process as we've just done. And then we'll reconvene and figure out how to do the bits that are traveling away from the body. So things like this here. And over on the other side, things like this here. Okay, so I will see you after the break.